Hi everyone, it's Nadia from Yarn Utopia. Today we are making an anatomically correct heart. This looks so awesome and it was a lot of fun to make, and you can make your own just by following along with this video. These are great for, you know, teaching tools. You know, can teach kids the parts of the heart. This is great for any nerdy Valentine as well. You know, you can give somebody your heart literally and figuratively. Also, this is a great piece to give, you know, to your professor, your anatomy professor or teacher, so they can use it in the classroom. Or if somebody's, you know, getting heart surgery, you can give it to somebody, give them a new heart. So there's great ideas for this as a little gift idea for somebody, this little amigurumi heart. So but the supplies we're going to need today are all Red Heart yarns. I actually don't know the specific color name for this. I just had scraps of this color. It's a hot coral color for the main part of the heart. So if you know the color, the name of this color, please leave a comment on this video so we all can see what the name of this color is. But I'm just using Red Heart yarns and just blue and red as well, and then that coral color. We also need some polyfill to stuff our heart, and then the size hook we are going to use for this project is a G size hook, G6, which is a 4.25 millimeter hook. So there it is. So you can see that and get that size hook handy, as well as a yarn needle and a scissor, because we are going to be cutting our yarn and sewing in our ends and sewing on these pieces. It's a lot of sewing today. We're going to be sewing on these pieces, you know, all the pieces. So we're going to need that sewing needle. And then before I get started, I do want to mention, please check out the links in the description of this video. I'll have a link to the blog where you can find out where to get this video tutorial pattern, all that good stuff. Also, there's a link to my Facebook. Make sure to join me on Facebook. And if you make this heart, be sure to share your photos on Facebook. I would love to see your creations. Also, share your work on Instagram and be sure to follow me on Instagram. And if you make this heart, be sure to hashtag YarnUtopia on Instagram so that I can see your work. And go follow me on Instagram and like my photos as well. Also, follow me on Snapchat. I'll put my username in the description of this video. It's just YarnUtopia. And also, follow me on Twitter too. My username on there is in the description of this video. Also, subscribe to my channel here on YouTube. Just click that red subscribe button. And also, if you can, if you would, just go to my channel on YouTube. On the right-hand side, there's a blue button that says support. Be sure to click that and support us, please, so that we can keep bringing you fantastic crochet tutorials. I want to say thank you to those who have clicked that button and supported us so far. That is greatly appreciated. And also, nail polish. I have this nail polish on today. This one is called Sinful Shine. So if you want to get like me and wear the same nail polish as me, you can get Sinful Shine in Oat Shine. So that's the color today I'm using in this video. So you can get like me and make that your nail color as well. So without further ado, let's just get started in making this heart organ. This is an anatomically correct heart. Alright, to start out, we're going to start off with our hot coral-ish color and make a slip knot. So put your short end over the long end, fold that down, and pull that through, and pull tight. We're going to be making the main part of the heart here. So to start off, we have to chain two. So yarn over, pull through, one and two. And then in the second chain from the hook, we are going to put six single crochets. So the loop that's on your hook never counts, so count one and two. Insert your hook right into that chain, yarn over, pull through, and then yarn over and pull through two loops. Okay, that's a single crochet. So put one, that was one, go back into that chain, yarn over, pull through two. That's two. Insert your hook back in there, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through two. That's three. Insert your hook, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through two. That's four, five, and six. Okay, now at this point you want to put a stitch marker in your work because we're working in continuous rounds, so it's just best to put a stitch marker in there. I'm just going to put a piece of yarn that's a different color in there. If you have a legit stitch marker, you can put that in there at this time. And on this project, we are working in the back loops only. So usually in projects, we work through both loops like this. But on this project, we're working in the back loop. So this is the back loop. This is the front loop. So back loop, front loop, back loop, front loop. So we're just working in the back loops only on this whole project, on all pieces of this heart. So in this next round, round two, we are going to put two single crochet in each stitch around in the back loop only. So insert your hook right into this first stitch, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through two loops. Okay, again, back into that same stitch, yarn over, pull through two loops. So two single crochet in that same stitch. In the next stitch, put two single crochet, back loop only. So just insert your hook, yarn over, pull through two. Okay, so two single crochet right in there. Hop to the next and put two single crochet in there. Okay, and just do that in each stitch around. At the end of this round, you will have 12 single crochet. So I'm almost there, just two more stitches. Okay, and then when you get back around to the beginning, this is what it should look like. You can put your stitch marker up, just like that. And now, going on to round three, we are just putting one single crochet into each stitch around. So no increasing on this round, we're just putting one single crochet in each stitch in the back loops only, just like this. Okay, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, and 12. Okay, going on to round four, we are going to move our stitch marker up and we are going to increase on this round. So we are going to put two single crochet in the first stitch right here. One and two, and then one single crochet in the next stitch. Okay, and then we're just going to repeat that all the way around. So two single crochet in the next stitch, one and two, and then one single crochet in the next stitch, one. Then two single crochet in the next stitch, one and two, and then one single crochet in the next stitch. So at the end of this round, round four, you will have 18 single crochets. So I will meet you up when I have my 18 and we'll go on to round five together. All right, going on to round five, I'm moving my stitch marker up. I have 18 single crochet around, and now on round five, we are just going to put one single crochet into each stitch around. So we're not increasing on round five. And we are just putting one single crochet into each stitch around for 18 single crochet. And then I'll just do that and then I'll meet you up and we'll go on to round six for an increase. All right, just moving my stitch marker up. I just put one single crochet in each stitch around for round five. So now going on to round six, we are going to do an increase. We are going to be putting two single crochet in the first stitch. One and two. And then one single crochet in each of the next two stitches. So just put one single crochet in the next two, so one and one, and then repeat that around. So put two single crochet in the next, one and two, and then in the next two stitches, we're just going to put one single crochet in each one of those, so one and one. Okay, hop to the next. We're going to put two single crochet in the next stitch, and then one single crochet in the next two stitches. So I'm going to do that around. You'll have 24 single crochet at the end of this round, so I'll meet you up and we'll go on to round seven together. Okay, going up to round 7, we are moving our stitch marker up and we need to increase again. So in this next round, we are going to put 2 single crochet in the first stitch, 1 and 2, and then 1 single crochet in the next 3 stitches this time. So just 1, 1, and 1. Okay, and then repeat. So put 2 single crochet in the next stitch, and then 1 single crochet in each of the next 3 stitches. 1, 2, and 3. Okay, then 2 single crochet in the next, and then 1 single crochet in the next 3 stitches. At the end of round 7, you will have 30 single crochet. So then I'll just meet you up and we'll go on to round 8 together. Alright, going on to round 8, just moving my stitch marker up, and we are going to make another increase. So right now for round 7, I have 30 single crochets around. So for round 8, I want to increase again. We are going to put 2 single crochet in the first stitch, 1 and 2, and then 1 single crochet in each of the next 4 stitches this time. So 1, 2, 3, and 4. And then repeat that around. So put 2 single crochet in the next stitch, and then 1 single crochet in each of the next 4 stitches, and then repeat. So at the end of this round, you will have 36 single crochets, and then we'll go on to round 9 together. Alright, I'm just moving my stitch marker up. I have my 36 single crochet, so now going on to round 9, we are going to do another increase. We are going to put 2 single crochet in the first stitch, 1 and 2, and then we're going to put 1 single crochet in each of the next 5 stitches this time. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, and then repeat. So put 2 single crochet in the next stitch, okay, and then 1 single crochet in the next 5 stitches. And then just repeat that all the way around. So at the end of this round, we will have 42 single crochet. So then I'll meet you up and we'll go on to round 10. Alright, just finished round 9. So I have 42 single crochet around, and I feel like that is large enough for this anatomical heart. So now, going on to rounds 10 through 14, okay, so the next 5 rounds, we are just going to be putting 1 single crochet into each stitch around, so no increasing. You'll have 42 single crochet on each one of these rounds, rounds 10 through 14. So I'm just going to do that, and once I finish round 14, I'll meet you up and we'll go on to round 15 together to do our decreases to close the top of the heart. Alright, so I just finished round 14 here, so you have rounds 10, 11, 12, 13, and 14, all just done with 1 single crochet around, so you have 42 single crochets. This is what it looks like so far. So now, going on to round 15, we are going to decrease. So I'm going to move my stitch marker up. And then we want to put a single crochet decrease over these first 2 stitches. So one, oh, I'm sorry. We have to insert our hook into this first stitch, yarn over, pull through, jump all the way to the next stitch, and then yarn over and pull through. And then yarn over and pull through all 3 loops on your hook, and that's a single crochet decrease. We just made these 2 single crochets into 1. Okay, then we want to single crochet 1 single crochet, just a regular single crochet, in the next 5 stitches. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Okay, and then we want to repeat that around. So we're going to make a single crochet decrease. So insert your hook in this next stitch, yarn over, pull through, go directly into the next stitch, yarn over, pull through, and then yarn over and pull through all 3 loops on your hook, and then do a regular single crochet in the next 5 stitches. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Again, single crochet decrease, so insert your hook in the next stitch, yarn over, pull through, jump to the next, yarn over, pull through, and yarn over and pull through all 3 loops on your hook, There we go. And then just do a regular single crochet in the next 5 stitches. So just repeat that around, and at the end of this round, you will have 36 single crochets again. So I will meet you up, and we'll go on to round 16 together. Alright, just finishing up this round here. I'm going to move my stitch marker up. Going on to round 16, we're going to do another decrease. So insert your hook in this next stitch right here, yarn over, pull through, go into the next stitch, yarn over, pull through, and then yarn over and pull through all 3 loops on your hook for a single crochet decrease. And then we're going to put 1 single crochet in the next 4 stitches. So just a regular single crochet, 1, 2, 3, and 4. And then we're going to repeat that. So put a single crochet decrease. So go into this next stitch, yarn over, pull through, go into the next stitch, yarn over, pull through, and then yarn over and pull through all 3 loops on your hook. And then put 1 single crochet in the next 4 stitches. So 1, 2, 3, and 4. And then again, single crochet decrease, and then 1 single crochet in the next 4 stitches. And then just do that around. At the end of this round, you will have 30 single crochets. So I'll meet you up and we'll go on to round 17 together. Alright, I just finished round 16. I have 30 single crochets around, moving my stitch marker up. Going on to round 17, we're going to do another decrease. So in this first 2 stitches, we're going to do a single crochet decrease. So go into this first stitch, yarn over, pull through, go into the next stitch, yarn over, pull through all 3 loops. And then we're only going to put 1 single crochet in the next 3 stitches this time. So 1, 2, and 3. And then repeat. So put a single crochet decrease. Okay. And then 1 single crochet in the next 3 stitches. So 1, 2, and 3. Okay. And then again, decrease. And then 1 single crochet in the next 3 stitches. And then just repeat that around. At the end of this round, you'll have 24 single crochet. So I'll meet you up and we'll go on to round 18 together. Alright, I just finished round 17. I have 24 single crochet around. I'm going to move my stitch marker up and go on to round 18. We are going to do a single crochet decrease over these first 2 stitches and then 1 single crochet in the next 2 stitches. So 1 and 1. And then repeat that. So put a single crochet decrease, insert your hook, yarn over, pull through, go into the next stitch, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, and pull through all 3 loops. And then 1 single crochet in the next 2 stitches. At the end of round 18, you will have 18 single crochet. So I'll meet you up, and after this round, we are going to start stuffing. Alright, after round 18, our hole is getting much smaller, so I'm just going to pull up this loop right here and remove my hook, and I'm going to grab my polyfill here, and what we're going to do is just take little chunks of it and just kind of put it inside and make sure that it goes all the way to the bottom and just distribute it evenly inside of this heart piece. Okay, so I'm just stuffing it as much as I can right now, and then after the next round, we'll stuff some more, and after the next round, we'll stuff some more. And you want to kind of manipulate it to make it look like an actual heart, anatomical heart, that is. Okay. Don't overstuff it, but just stuff it enough, okay? And then you can kind of stretch it out to make it look like a heart. There we go. Okay, this is so cool. So now I'm going to insert my hook back into the loop there, pull it tight, And then we can go on to round 19. And for round 19, we are going to do a single crochet decrease. Right, let me move my stitch marker up. There we go. Single crochet decrease over these first two stitches, and then one single crochet in the next stitch. Okay, so it's going to be a little bit difficult now that we have the stuffing inside. It's going to try and stretch it, so you kind of just have to manipulate it with your other fingers. Okay, then we're just going to repeat that around. So a single crochet decrease, and then one single crochet in the next stitch. Okay, then a single crochet decrease, and then one single crochet in the next stitch. So at the end of round 19, you will have 12 single crochets, and then I'll meet you up and we'll go on to round 20. Alright, just finishing round 19 here, and now moving my stitch marker up, and also stuffing this just a little bit more. Just getting everything, because this next round we're going to be closing this piece forever. So just making sure that I have enough stuffing in there. Move your stitch marker up, and on round 20 we are going to decrease in each stitch. So no more, you know, we're just going to be decreasing. So this, go into this first stitch, yarn over, pull through, go into the next stitch, yarn over, pull through, and then yarn over and pull through all three loops. Hop to the next stitch, go in, yarn over, pull through, go into the next stitch, yarn over, pull through all three loops. Okay, again, go into the next stitch, yarn over, pull through, go into the next stitch, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through all three loops. Go into the next stitch, yarn over, pull through, go into the next stitch, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through all three loops. Okay, two more. Go into the next stitch, yarn over, pull through, go into the next stitch, yarn over, pull through all three loops. And last one here, go into this next stitch, there you go, yarn over, pull through, go into the next stitch, yarn over, pull through all three loops. So now you only have six stitches around, okay? If you can, you know, insert some more stuffing, if you're able to get it through that little tiny opening there. Okay. And now for this very last step here to close this little gap, we are going to go into this first stitch right here. And then count, skip the next two stitches, so two and three stitch, and go into the fourth stitch right across the way. Okay, just like that, going across here, and then yarn over, pull through both of those. Okay, if you can, there we go. And then yarn over and pull through two loops. Okay, that's just one single crochet. Then I'm going to cut my yarn. And to fasten off, I usually chain up one and then pull that all the way through and pull tight. And then to hide this piece, well, first I'm going to remove my stitch marker, okay, and then kind of get all this fuzz off of here. And then to hide this straggler, what I usually do is go in with my hook down below, go all the way through to the very top right here, yarn over with that straggler, and pull it inside of the piece. Okay, there we go. Just remove my hook, stretch this out, kind of get all the fuzz off of there, and remove that, and there you have it. Whoa, this is gonna look awesome. So now we have to make the other pieces of the heart, which are the right and left pulmonary artery and the aorta, and then some veins to give it some detail. So get your red yarn out. I'm gonna set this aside here. Okay, get some red yarn. Make a slip knot, so put your short end over the long end, fold that down and pull that through. And we are going to make the aorta. So to do that, we are going to chain 9. So yarn over, pull through. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. And then our chain, we're looking at it like this. We are going to turn this over like this. So we're looking at the back ridges toward us. And then we are going to fold this in half so that the first chain comes toward by our hook, like this. Okay? And now we are going to work into this first chain right here. And we are going to put our hook inside of there, into that chain. Okay? Then yarn over, pull through, and then yarn over and pull through 2 loops. So we just made a single crochet into that first chain there. And we are just going to single crochet around. So insert your hook, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through 2. Okay, next chain, insert your hook, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through 2. Next chain, insert your hook, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through 2. So you'll have 9 single crochets at the end of this round. We're just making kind of like a tube, which is similar to what an aorta may look like. Okay, and last 2 here, just like that. Okay, so now if you need to count back, you have 9, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. And if you need to, put a stitch marker in there, but I'm not going to. We're just going to work in the back loops only. And for rounds 2 through 6, so 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, the next 5 rounds, we are just going to single crochet around in the back loops only. Just insert your hook, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through 2. Okay, just do that all the way around. We're just putting 1 single crochet in each stitch for rounds 2 through 6, and then I will meet you up and we'll go on to round 7 together. Alright, so I just finished round 6 here. So now, going on to round 7, we are going to be doing this for rounds 7 through 13. So 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. So the next 7 rounds, we are going to be single crocheting in the first 5 stitches. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, and then in the last 4 stitches we are going to slip stitch, but with these slip stitches we are going to make them loose slip stitches. So just insert your hook, yarn over, pull through and through, but don't pull tight. Then just pull up that loop, go into the next stitch, yarn over, pull through and through. Okay, go into the next stitch, yarn over, pull through and through, and in the last stitch insert your hook, yarn over, pull through and through. Okay, so we're just doing that for round 7, which we just did, and then 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. So after round 13, there will start to be a curve here where these slip stitches are. So again, I'll show you in round 8, we're going to just slip or single crochet in the next 5 stitches, so 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, and then in these next 4 stitches we're going to slip stitch. So insert your hook, yarn over, pull through and through. So 1, 2, 3, and 4. Okay, so then going on to round 9, we're going to single crochet in these first 5 stitches and then slip stitch in the last 4 stitches. So I'm just going to do that for this round 9, 10, 11, 12, and 13, and I'll meet you up when I'm going on to round 14. Alright, so I just finished round 13 here, and this is kind of what it looks like. You can kind of see that it is curving here, and when we manipulate it a little bit, when we sew it to the piece, it will be a little bit more curved like this. But now for the rest of the rounds, for rounds 14 through 17, we are just going to put one single crochet into each stitch around. So I'm just going to do that, and then I'll meet you up when I finish round 17. Just put one single crochet in each stitch around for 14, 15, 16, and 17, and then I'll show you how to fasten off. Alright, so I'm just finishing round 17 here, and then we want to just slip stitch into this next stitch. Just insert your hook, yarn over, pull through and through to fasten off. I usually like to chain up one. And then we're going to cut our yarn semi-long because we will be using that for sewing. And then just continue pulling that all the way through and pull tight. Okay, so now you can kind of shape this so it looks more like this. Oh, there's an arch. Okay. And if you want, if it's giving you a little kink in the middle there, you can take a tiny little bit of polyfill and kind of just put it inside there. If you can get your, either like your crochet hook or something small, your pinky finger in there so that it can keep its shape. Okay, you can put a little bit of polyfill in this piece. But we don't want to stuff it too much because we want to give it, make it more flexible. Okay, so then this piece is going to be going on our heart more like this. Okay, but we have to make the other pieces first. So there, it'll go like this. Or maybe it goes like this. And then the blue, the pulmonary artery goes through here like that. But we'll figure that out later. So now get your blue. And we are going to make pretty much the same exact thing that we just made. So make a slip knot, put your short end over the long end, fold that down and pull that through. Okay, and whoops, pull tight, there we go. And now for the pulmonary artery, we are going to obviously use blue, and we are going to chain 8 this time. So yarn over, pull through, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. So this one is a little bit smaller than the other one by one stitch. So then we're going to turn this toward us just like that. Fold this in half so the beginning chain comes toward our hook. And we are going to single crochet into this first chain here like this. So insert your hook, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through 2. So that's 1. Going to the next for a single crochet, 2, in the next, 3, in the next, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. So you just want to single crochet around this piece so that it looks like this. So now you're at a ring. Now going on to rounds 2 through 5, so just the next few rounds, we are just going to put one single crochet in each stitch around for rounds 2, 3, 4, and 5, so the next 4 rounds here. And then for rounds 6 through 12, we are going to start making our curve. Okay, so I just finished round 5 here, so now going on to round 6, we are going to single crochet in the first 4 stitches. So 1, 2, 3, and 4, and then we are going to slip stitch in the last 4 stitches. Very similar to how we made the aorta, we are going to just insert our hook, yarn over, pull through, and through. Okay, insert your hook, yarn over, pull through, and through. Insert your hook, yarn over, pull through, and through. Insert your hook, and yarn over, and pull through, and through. Okay, so then single crochet in the next 4 stitches. 1, 2, 3, 4. This is now round 7. Okay, and then slip stitch in the next 4 stitches. So round 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. So round 6 through 12, we are doing this. So I'll meet you up when I finish round 12, and then we'll go on to round 13 together. Alright, so I just finished round 12 here, so now for rounds 13 through 16, we are just going to single crochet in each stitch around. So no more slip stitching, we are just going to single crochet in rounds 13, 14, 15, and 16, just single crochet in each stitch around, and then I'll meet you up when I finish round 16 and we will fasten off. When you finish round 16, we're just going to go into the next stitch, yarn over, pull through and through to slip stitch, and then to fasten off, we're going to chain one and cut our yarn kind of long because we're going to use that for sewing, and then pull that all the way through and pull tight. Okay, and then you can see here that this has our curve to it, so then this one is going to go like this, and then this red one is going to go over the top of it like this. Okay. And now we have to make some more embellishments. We have to make tubes that kind of come, two tubes that come off of the blue, and then three tubes that come off of the aorta, and then we have to make some veins, little embellishments. So to start that though, I'm gonna sew these two pieces on so we have them positioned. So and I'm going to also stuff this just slightly, like kind of similar to how I did the aorta, the red tube. So I'm just going to shove in some polyfill in here. Okay. It's a little bit more on this side. There we go. Okay. And then I'm going to stretch this out, kind of manipulate it to go the way I want it to. And then I'm going to decide which part of the heart I want to be the top. And I'm going to position this like this. Okay, and I'm going to sew that down. So I'm going to take my yarn needle, take my my straggler on this end. Okay, so you want the blue ones to go the long way, like this. Okay, so pretty much like around round like 4 or 5, I'm just going to whip stitch this. Okay, just like that. And then to tie that off, we're going to go through a few stitches and then put our finger in that loop and then go around, go back into that loop and pull tight, and then I'm just going to sew in this blue into this pulmonary thing here, there we go, and just cut extra, stretch it out to hide that. Okay, and now we want to position the other end to go about right here. Okay, so I'm going to yarn my needle and sew that on the same way as I did the top part. Okay, so I'm just going to go under a few stitches and then through and through. And then just sew that on, just like that. Okay, and then I'm going to fasten it off very similarly how I did the other one. Just go through a few stitches here, insert my finger in that loop, go back around, and then pull that tight. Okay, then insert this back into the blue. Cut any extra, stretch that out, and then manipulate this so that it looks like how it's supposed to, like that. Okay? Then we want the red part, the aorta, to go over the top of that, like this. Okay? and you want it to go more toward the top, so there's more blue here. You don't want it to go like right over the center. You kind of want it facing this way, like this. Okay, gotta make this anatomically correct as much as we can for a crochet piece, I guess. So take your straggler from this end, position this where you want it to go, about right here, and just sew this just like how we did the blue one, just by whip stitching around. So I'm just going to sew this one on, and then I'll meet you up and we'll go on to the next step of making the other embellishments. Alright, so I just sewed on this red part here, and it's on top of this blue part, just like that. Okay, so this is what the heart looks like so far. So now we just have to put a little bit more embellishments on here. We want to put two blue kind of like tubes on each side here, and then three tubes on this red piece here. So I'll show you how to do one of them, but then you can make the other four off, you know, on your own. So get your blue yarn first. I'm gonna set that aside. And we want to make a slip knot. So put your short end over the long end, fold that down, and pull that through. Pull tight. Okay, and now we're going to work basically very similar to how we made the aorta and those pulmonary, whatever they're called, the other pieces of the heart. So chain six, so yarn over, pull through, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, and then we're going to turn this toward us. We're going to fold this in half so that this first chain comes to the hook. We're going to insert our hook into that first chain, okay, and then yarn over, pull through, and then yarn over and pull through 2. Okay, so this is going on to round 1 right away. So that's a single crochet, and we're going to single crochet in each chain around. So that's a total of 6 single crochets. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Okay, so that was round 1. Now rounds 2 through 8, we are just single crocheting in each stitch around. So we're just putting 1 single crochet in each stitch around, and then once I finish round 8, I'll meet you up and I'll show you how to go on to the next step. Alright, once you finish round 8, you would just want to go in this next stitch here, and then yarn over, pull through, and pull through. And then to fasten off, I just chain up 1, and then we're going to cut our yarn kind of long, because we're going to use that for sewing. And then pull that all the way through, and pull tight. Okay, so this is what it looks like so far. So now, what I want to do is take my hook and go up from the bottom up to the top, and hook on that straggler that we just cut, okay, and pull that all the way through, and then we're going to kind of pull tight to kind of curl that down, okay, and we got to make this shorter, so we want to stuff this inside, just continue pushing it through. Okay, and you can use, you know, a crochet hook or your pinky or something small that will fit in there. Okay, and then you can manipulate this so that it looks like a tube. There we go. Okay, so you kind of got to shape it. And there you have it. So this is what we want it to look like. So you have to make 2 in blue, so I just made 1 in blue, so make 1 more in this blue color, and then make 3 in total in red. Okay, so I made these ones off camera, you can see here, and I made this middle one here is a little bit taller than these two, because when I pulled that through, I only folded it in just a little bit. So these other two are folded in complete half, in just like how we made this one, okay, and then I made another blue one off camera, like that. So these two are the same size, these two are the same size, and then this one is a little bit taller. And this one is going to be in our middle of our red. So once you have all five of these all complete, we can sew them to the heart, and we are almost done. So what we have to do is basically sew them onto these pieces exactly how we sewed these pieces onto the heart. So we're going to put one blue one here and the other blue one on this side. Okay, so it's going to go like this. And then the three red ones are going to go like this. Okay, just like that. So I'm going to sew these on, and to do that, just need my yarn needle and the longer end of our straggler. Okay, we'll have to have some coordination here. And then we're going to just go whip stitch it around this piece. Okay, just like that. Okay, and then to fasten them off, I'm actually going to tie them in a knot with our other straggler here. Just tie it in a knot and another knot. Okay, then I'm going to trim these short and manipulate this a little bit and then grab my yarn needle and take these two stragglers and put them on my yarn needle, and then I'm just going to sew them in to my piece. To hide them if I can. There we go. Okay, stretch it out and cut any extra. And there you have it. Okay, so that one is done. And now I'm just going to move on to this one here and put this one right here. And then I'm just going to sew those other ones exactly like we sewed these ones in that order. This two short ones on the ends and then this tall one in the center. And then once I have all these pieces lined up and sewn on, I will meet you up and we'll go on to the next step. Alright, so our heart is really coming together now. I just sewed on these three pieces and then this piece here. So we have the two on the blue and then the three on the red. And now our last embellishment is just making a vein, or two veins, I guess, coming down here to kind of give it a little embellishment. So what we have to do, we're going to do one in red and one in blue. So I'm just going to show you how to do it in red here. Just make a slip knot, so put your short end over the long end, fold that down, and then pull that through and pull tight. And then we're just going to chain 25. So yarn over, pull through. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, and 25. Then we're going to cut this straggler long because we are going to use that for sewing and pull that all the way through and pull tight. Okay, so this is our chain. Now make one more of those in blue like this. Okay, so we have a red one and a blue one. And now we are going to sew these onto our heart. So take your, let's see, we'll do the blue one first, and you want to take the long end and yarn your needle with that. And then what we're going to do is take our heart and we're going to put this from the back to the front around this red piece here, like this. Okay, and we are going to sew it from the back. And it's going to come around here and up around here, just like this, okay? So that's how it's going to look. And we are just going to go in and out. I don't know if you can see that in there. But I'm just going in and then out, just like that, grab my needle, and pull that tight. Okay, and then just go in and out. Come down a little bit, make it a little wavy. Okay, and then come around this piece here, just like that. And in and out there. Okay, then to fasten this off, I'm going to come back up through here. And then I'm going to go into this piece right here. Okay, and then I'm going to tie these two ends together in a knot. Okay. Pull tight. And then we just want to snip this and then yarn our needle with those two pieces. And just sew those in to the heart. And I just squeeze it, pull it if I can. You don't want to lose your needle inside of the heart. That would be terrible. There we go. And then you can cut any extra. You can stretch this out so that it has its shape still and that's hidden inside. Okay. And now we just have to sew on the red one. So the red one is going to be intertwined with the blue one, and we will do that by yarning this needle first. Okay, we're going to go in like we did with the blue one and around this red piece here. And it's going to start at the same spot. You can see where it started right there. We're going to start at the same spot. We're going to go next to it right here. And then around this area, we are going to go over the top, and then if you can, pull up your blue vein there and pull this underneath like this, and then have it end in the same spot on this side right here. Okay? So I'm going to sew that in just like I did with the blue one, just going in and then out of the chain. And then in and out. Whoops. There we go. And then in and out. And then you can tack it even onto that. There we go. And now, this part, you obviously want this to be underneath this blue. So we're just going to go underneath the blue and out through the red. Just like that. And then I'm going to go out through here, like this. And then I'm going to tie these two in a knot. Okay, and then I'm going to trim them short, pull them on my yarn needle here, yarn my needle, and then go into the heart. Okay, and you can stretch it out so those get hidden inside. And there you have it. Our anatomically correct heart. It's not completely like 100,000% correct, but it looks like a heart, and I mean, I think it looks like a heart. You can add some more embellishments if you know how to make these tubes. You can add more blue tubes, you know, coming down here. I mean, there's so many parts to the heart. The inferior vena cava, or vena cava, comes down here, and then we have the right and left pulmonary arteries right here. This is the superior vena cava. And then the aorta, this whole red piece is the aorta. And we have the endocardium, the myocardium, it's all in this piece right here. And the epicardium, that's all this coral piece here, okay? So you can, you know, look up online, you know, a picture of a heart and get all the pieces, the parts, and kind of make your own. We have, you know, the right and left pulmonary veins should be coming outward here. So, I mean, those are red, and you can add those if you'd like, but that is our heart. So, thank you so much for watching and learning how to make this heart. That was a lot of fun, and it looks really cool. So, you can give this to your Valentine, give them an actual heart for Valentine's Day. You can give this to somebody who is a super nerd, who's a Edgar Allan Poe fan, you can give this to a child who wants to learn about the heart pieces and where the heart, what parts of the heart are, you know, this organ. So you can give it to your anatomy teacher or your professor or something as a gift. You know, there's endless ideas to give a heart to somebody. So, and you can give somebody your heart figuratively, but literally, for Valentine's Day. That's what I'm gonna do. So, thank you so much for watching. Make sure to check out those links in the description of this video. You can get the link to the blog, link to my Facebook, link to my Instagram, my Snapchat and Twitter username, so follow me everywhere. Thanks to my dad, Fuad Asmat, for taking the time out to make this heart with us. He's our videographer, editor, and photographer for all of our videos. So thank you so much. Thanks for watching again, and happy hooking!